Hello and welcome to this week's edition of For His Glory.
你好，欢迎你收看这个星期的荣耀归神系列。
This week again, we're going to continue our study on faith and how faith is operative and works in our life.
今天我们要继续探讨的课题就是信心，同时我们要看一看信心如何在我们的生命里头运作和行事。
Just as a brief review, Galatians 5:6 says that faith works by love.
我们做一个简短的复习，那就是加拉太书五章六节说到呢，唯有在爱心里头呢，才能够启动信心。
So the energizing force, that which is the trip switch for faith to be activated in our life, is the love of God.
因此我们看到要是我们要启动这个信心的能力呢，它最主要的源头呢，就是来自神的爱。
That's why the Apostle James made the following statement in his letter to the body of Christ.
因此雅各写信给基督的肢体的时候，他在书信里头这样说。
In James 2:14 through 18, it says, What does it profit, my brethren, though a man say he has faith and has not works, can faith save him? If a brother or sister is naked and destitute of daily food, and one of you says to them, Depart in peace, be warmed and filled, notwithstanding you give them not those things which are needful to their body, what does it profit? Even so, faith, if it has not works, is dead,being alone. Yes, a man may say, you have faith and I have works. Show me your faith without your works, and I'll show you my faith by my works.
雅各书第二章十四到十八节，我的弟兄们，若有人说自己有信心，却没有行为，有什么益处呢？这信心能救他吗？若是弟兄或是姐妹赤身露体，又缺了日用的饮食，你们中间有人对他们说，平平安安的去吧，愿你们穿得暖吃得饱，却不给他们身体所需用的，这有什么益处呢？这样信心若没有行为就是死的。必有人说，你有信心，我有行为，你将你没有行为的信心指给我看，我便借着我的行为将我的信心指给你看。
Therefore, the works that faith produces are the evidence of the love of God in your heart.
从这里我们看到信心所产生的功效呢，它的明证就是神的爱。
James could just as easily have said, I will show you my love by my works.
其实雅各可以很直接地说，我借着我的工作来表现我的爱。
You see, if the Holy Spirit is the force by which love and faith come into being, then it must be necessary for you and I to be filled with the Spirit of God.
因此我们看到要是圣灵的大能啊，是借着爱和信心来行使的，那么呢，我们就必须容让自己的生命呢，被圣灵和被神的爱来充满，以至于呢，我们能够流露神的爱。
Let me say this again. If God is love, then Jesus as the outshining or the manifestation of God in the flesh is love, then the Spirit of God is love, and we have them dwelling within us.
让我这样说，如果神是爱，而这一份的爱呢，是透过主耶稣基督的道成肉身，把这份爱彰显出来的话，那么我们必须要容让这样的一份爱呢，也在我们的生命当中运作。唯有这样呢，我们才能够流露神的爱。
Therefore, we have a deposit within us of the love of God that we have to learn how to release, to uncap, to take over our spirit man and come forth through us.
在我们的生命里头呢，其实神的爱已经内住在里头了。所以我们所要做的是如何让我们里面这个属灵的人能够让他活化起来，好让这一份内住在心中的神的爱呢能够启动出来。
In Ephesians 5:17-20, it says, Therefore, do not be unwise, but understanding what the will of the Lord is. And do not be drunk with wine, wherein is excess, but be filled continually with the Spirit, speaking to yourselves in psalms and hymns and spiritual songs, singing and making melody in your heart to the Lord, giving thanks always for all things unto God and the Father in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ.
因此以弗所书第五章十七到二十节这样说，不要做糊涂人，要明白主的旨意如何，不要醉酒，酒能使人放荡，乃要被圣灵充满，当用诗章、颂词、灵歌彼此对说，口唱心和的赞美主，凡事要奉我们主耶稣基督的名，常常感谢父神。
So the will of God is for you and I to continually be filled with the Spirit of God.
因此呢，神的旨意乃是要我们的生命啊，常常的被圣灵充满。
Or we could say it this way.God wants us to continually be filled with His love.
换句话说，神希望我们的生命呢，能够持续的被神的爱充满。
Scripture says that perfect love, that's God's love, perfect love casts out all fear.
圣经告诉我们，完全的爱，也就是从神而来的爱，能够把我们心中的惧怕除去。
There are many times in the prayer line when people come up for prayer and they're facing fear. And the Lord has instructed us to pray that His perfect love would infuse them because perfect love casts out fear and the torment that comes with it.
经常有人列队来要我为他们祷告的时候呢，他们所面对的就是惧怕。那那个时候呢，神就对我说，要为他们祷告，让完全的爱，也就是神的爱，来渗透他们的生命。因为完全的爱，神的爱，能够把心中的惧怕驱除。
The love of God has been shed abroad in our hearts.
神的爱已经浇灌在我们的心里头。
Therefore, you have that which is necessary for you to walk in faith.
因此，在你的生命当中呢，已经具备了这样的条件，能够行走在信心里头。
As I develop in relationship with the Lord Jesus, I love Him more.As I love Him more, I trust Him more. As I trust Him more, faith is developed, and I release that through my mouth.
当我和耶稣基督建立更深的关系的时候呢，我更加的爱他。当我更加的爱他的时候呢，我对他有更多的信靠。当我更多的信靠他的时候呢，我对他有更大的信心。而当我有更大的信心的时候，我就能够透过我的口来宣讲信心的话语。
Again, Ephesians 5:17 says that the Lord wants to understand what His will is. He wants us to continually be filled with the Spirit of God.
所以以弗所书第五章十七节说呢，神的心意啊，乃是要我们明白神的旨意。当我们越是明白神的旨意的时候呢，神的灵就能够更大的来浇灌我们，充满我们。
As we are being continually filled with the Spirit, there's a natural overflow. We speak to ourselves in psalms and hymns and spiritual songs, making melody in our hearts to the Lord and giving Him thanks.
当神的灵浇灌我们，这个圣灵满溢的时候呢，我们口中就会发出诗章、颂词、灵歌，然后口唱心和的在神的面前赞美他。
Are you seeing the table of the Lord in this? Scripture and instruction says for us to drink of the Holy Spirit continually to the point where it overflows in our life.
你看到神的运作的方式吗？也就是说呢，我们的生命要不断的被圣灵充满，以致我们的生命里头的圣灵满意的时候呢，这个时候我们就能够将赞美归给神。
That overflowing of the Holy Spirit has to go somewhere, and that means it bubbles forth in the form of a demonstrative love, something that shows itself openly.
换句话说，当我们的生命被圣灵大大浇灌，而且充满满意的时候呢，我们所彰显出来的就是神的那份完全的爱。
John 3:34 and 35 says, For he whom God has sent speaks the words of God. He does not give the Spirit by measure. The Father loves the Son and has given all things into his hand.
约翰福音第三章三十四和三十五节说，神所差来的就说神的话，因为神赐圣灵给他是没有限量的，父爱子已将万有交在他手里。
You see, God has not given you the Spirit by measure. That Greek word for measure is metron. It means limited degree or a measured portion.
看到吗？圣经清楚地记载，神给我们的灵呢，是没有限量的。限量这个希腊文的字呢，就是说没有界限的，是无法测量的福分。
So God gives us the Spirit without measure. In other words, God gives us His love without measure.
这里说呢，神所赐的灵是没有限量的。换句话说呢，他所赐给我们的爱也是没有限量的。
There are many days.I find myself just saying in my heart, Father, I love you. Lord, I love you. And as I see people in their everyday work life, the overflow of the love of God in my heart, I just start asking God to bless individuals, or I begin to pray for them because we have the Spirit without measure.
很多时候呢，我常常对父神说，父神啊，我很爱你。我对主耶稣说，主啊，我很爱你。当我的心中充满了神的爱的时候，我看到周围的人的状况呢，我就会去为这些人代祷，愿神的爱充满他们的生命。
That's not a boast so that you will look at me, but it's an example from my life of the overflow of the love of God that is operative in me because of developed relationship.
我并不是在你的面前夸耀。我乃是要告诉你，当我和神有着非常亲密的关系的时候呢，神的爱就无限量地充满我的生命，以致我的生命里头的爱满意的时候呢，这一份的爱呢，使到我愿意去为别人祝福，去为别人祷告。
Because of that Spirit of God, that overflow of the Spirit of God in me, I can confidently say, my God is for me, not against me.
正因为我的生命里头满溢着神的爱，所以我可以非常肯定地说，神是站在我这一边的，神并 不是与我作对的。
When faced with the challenge of sickness or disease, I can with assurance say, by the stripes of Jesus, I was healed. So sickness and disease must leave my body.
当我面对疾病或者是患病的时候呢，我能够很有信心地说，因着主耶稣的鞭伤，我必得医治，并且呢，我能够因着神所赐给我的信心呢，叫这个疾病或者是病症离开我的身体。
Because of relationship and the overflow of the Spirit and the love of God, I can say boldly that I can do all things through Christ who gives me His strength.
因着我和神亲密的关系，因着神那满意的爱在我的生命里头，所以呢，我可以非常的肯定的说，靠着神所加给我的力量，凡事都能做。
Because of that relationship with the Lord, I can speak forth His word with a peace and assurance and a faith, knowing that His word is true in my life.
因着神在我心中这一份满意的爱，因着我和他的关系，因此呢，我能够宣告出充满着平安和慈爱的话语。
See, the table of the Lord has not been set before us so that we can just barely get enough of His Word and a little bit of His Holy Spirit to go along with it. It's been spread so that we can eat and eat and eat of the Word and of the Spirit until we are full and overflow.
主耶稣的这个桌子摆在我们的面前呢，不只是单单喂饱我们，就是单单用他的话语来喂饱我们而已，也不只是要我们只是沾到圣灵的一点边。主耶稣的桌子，当我们来到他的台前的时候呢，乃是叫我们在他的面前能够不断地享受他为我们所摆设的筵席，也就是他的话，还有印于圣灵。
And as we partake and hear in our spirits that rhema, that word of God generates the faith of Jesus in us to go forth empowered by Holy Spirit to accomplish God's purposes.
当我们在主耶稣的台前享受这一个丰盛的筵席的时候呢，圣灵呢就会在我们的心中呢来激起神所说的话，也就是 rhema。这样呢，使到我们在圣灵的里头更加的有能力来过每一天的生活。
The table of the Lord is the abundant life of Jesus that He came to give us. He said in John 10:10, "The thief comes not but to steal, to kill and destroy. But I am come that you might have life and life more abundantly."
主耶稣的台前呢，就是指主耶稣来到这个世上所要赐给我们的丰盛生命。主耶稣在约翰福音第十章第十节这里说，盗贼来无非要偷窃、杀害、毁坏，我来了是要叫羊得生命，并且得的更丰盛。
Everything about the table of the Lord is abundance. Everything about Jesus is abundance.
凡是有关于主耶稣台前的事物呢，都是丰盛的事物。凡是有关主耶稣本身的事物呢，也是丰盛的事物。
The overflow of the abundance of God was so much that Jesus came and gave His life for us.
由于神的丰盛在耶稣基督的里面满溢出来，这样呢，主耶稣就愿意舍命来到世上，将这丰盛的生命赐给我们。
The faith of Jesus is so abundant that He has given us the storehouse of the substance of faith to draw upon.
由于主耶稣的信心是那么的丰盛，所以呢，他已经把那一个有实质的信心的仓房啊，赐给我们。
And then the Holy Spirit has been given to us to facilitate that abundance and to provide us with a means to draw upon that reservoir of the substance of faith in heaven.
而圣灵赐给我们呢，就是作为我们的协助者，好让圣灵呢能够帮助我们能够接触到那在天国的这个资源，好让这些的资源呢在属灵的境界来到自然的境界呢能够成为真实的事情。
Some of you are wondering how we went from talking about faith to the table of the Lord. It's quite simple. If you truly believe that Jesus is who he says he is, then you partake of that table of the Lord, the communion, and faith is developed.
有些朋友听到这里的时候呢，可能有些疑问，那就是怎么谈信心会谈到主耶稣的台前呢？其实，如果你相信主耶稣就是道成肉身而来的生命的粮，那么当我们一起在主的面前守圣餐、吃饼和喝那个血的时候呢，其实我们就是在那边享用着主耶稣基督的生命。
Right now, just think about a challenge you're facing. Just put one thing in front of your mind's eye and then make a decision to reach into the realm of the Spirit and grab the substance of faith and begin to apply it to that challenge.
这个时候呢，请你想象一下你在这个星期里面所要面对的一个挑战，注目在这个挑战的里头。然后呢，把你的心思意念提升到属灵的境界，也就是提升到那一个充满了属灵实质的仓房里头，再从这个仓房的里头呢，拿出信心的实质，应用在你所要面对的挑战上。
As you do this, see yourself reaching into the realm of the Spirit.See yourself bringing forth this golden substance of faith and see it becoming the answer to your need and speak forth that answer.
当你这样做的时候呢，请你要在灵里面去想象，就是你进到这个天国里头信心的仓房里，拿出属于这个仓房里面的一些的宝藏，把它应用在你的挑战上，并且呢，用信心的话语来宣告这个天国的实质呢，将会应验在你所面对的挑战。
As you learn to engage prayer in this manner and release faith in this manner,You will begin to see answers come forth according to the purposes and the will of God.
当你这样去操练你的信心，并且说出信心的话语的时候呢，你就能够看到属于神的信心如何落实在你的生命里头。
Remember that the victory is in your mouth.
请你要记得，胜利就在你的口中。
Stop agreeing with the circumstance. Stop agreeing with the symptom. Start agreeing with the Word of God.
不要认同世界所说的话，不要认同状况所发出的声音，乃是要认同神所说的话。
And remember this week, as you are putting...This teaching into practice in your life, do all things for His glory.
当你这个星期把我所教导你的应用在生活当中的时候，记得你所做的一切都要将荣耀归给神。
我寻求你。我思爱你，听你声音，道有馨香，愿吸引我，
要是你想从 Bruce Allen 牧师的教导中领受更深的启发和见解，你可以到以下网址选购他所写的书籍。